When the first tulip appeared, all we knew is that it came from beyond Jupiter.
There's no question, sir. The target is heading directly toward Mars. Our projections indicate that it will probably land near the planet's south pole.
The evidence suggests that they intend to attack our colony. We must prevent it from landing on Mars at all costs. All vessels, hold your fire until the enemy enters your effective targeting range.
It's continuing to advance, sir. It'll be inside our range of fire in 20 seconds.
They're repelling all of our beam projectiles somehow, sir! We can't get near them!
It's some kind of gravitron wave shield.
Sir, we've got multiple small bogies emerging from the tulip!
All ships, fire with lasers! Impossible! We aren't getting any kills!
Admiral, the computer's predicting that the tulip will reach the South Pole in 60 seconds.
Abandon ship! We're gonna ram that thing!
HQ! You're wasting your time.
Huh?
Everything on the surface must have been vaporized.
Would you like one?
Well, thank you.
How kind.
Oh, no, I've got a whole crate of them here.
You're a nice man!
Mm.
Are you married? I'm I. What's your name?
Please don't panic! Keep firing! We've got to get these civilians out of here!
I'll try to hold that thing up! Get out of here!
All right.
Opening.
Now passed since the disastrous defeat at the First Battle of Mars. If the military continues to be unable to stop the invaders, the Earth will soon fall as well.
Which is quite unacceptable.
I have a question.
And what is that, Mr. Hori?
Exactly. What does this have to do with me?
The Schiaparelli project. Are you aware of it?
Of course.
We want to implement it. And due to your extensive military experience, we believe that you're the best choice for carrying it out.
I don't know. It's been a while since I wore a uniform.
Ah, but this assignment would involve a lot of lovely young women.
Oh?
And your bonus. Now, let's see. How's this?
May I ask you one other question?
Of course.
Is that after taxes?
Well, now that that's settled, let's assemble our human resources.
Our crew?
Yes, our crew. I've chosen the very best. Of course, a few of them have some slight personality disorders.
You've been doing this for 3 days, you know.
Quiet! A few more spot welds and Lily will be invincible.
Mr. Uribitaki?
I'm not him! This isn't what it looks like!
Hello there, I'm Lily!
The chief mechanic?
You're unlicensed, but very skilled.
Won't you join us?
Come on, let's go. I'm ready to boogie.
But don't you want to negotiate your contract first?
It's fine. I don't care. If it means getting away from those two, I'd work in the bowels of hell.
Are you sure about this, Miss Haruka? I thought you liked being the secretary to the company's president.
Well, I did. But this looks much more interesting.
It's time for us to fight!
All right, let's go!
Yeah!
Great! Fantastic!
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much.
Megumi!
Huh?
Take a breather. These gentlemen from Nergal would like to talk to you.
Huh?
Eureka!
Eureka, your father's starting to get upset.
Well, I'm sorry, but this uniform is just so... Oh, it's just not me.
It's a bit late to complain now.
I know. But speaking of late, are you sure quitting the UF to follow me to Nergal is such a good idea?
Well, I was worried that you might need help.
Oh, June, you're the best friend a girl could ask for.
Yeah, sure.
Eureka! Damn it, Eureka! You were supposed to leave an hour ago!
Daddy!
Now act like an officer!
But
then come on,
she's still getting dressed right now!
My little girl is a woman. Not only is she an officer, but she's well endowed as well, Eureka. Your daddy is very proud.
Evil wizards from Jupiter are attacking the Earth.
It's time to knock them out with our united fists.
United forces protect the Earth.
This has been a message from the United States.
Not another air raid.
Hey, what's holding up my stir fry? Hey, not again.
Well, there goes another one.
When will they realize they're no match for the Jovians?
Dudes, the fry cook's freaking out!
Huh?
Hey, your fry cook's not sick, is he?
Nah, just scared.
Of what?
The Jovians.
Oh, damn, I burned it.
I'm sorry, Akito, but I put 2 weeks' severance pay on your card.
You mean I'm fired?
I'm afraid so. Look, there's a war going on, and if word gets out that I've got a yellow pilot working here...
What? It's all because of this?
Only pilots have those on Earth, Akito. And after everyone saw the way you froze up today...
But this job is the only thing I had.
I know, and I'm sorry. But you can't keep running away from your problems forever, you know.
Damn it! What's wrong with running away? And whose business is it anyway? Okay, so maybe I do need to confront my fears, but how can I stand up to my nightmares if my legs are running like nature intended? I'm brave, but my feet aren't. Damn feet! Ah, you jerk! Ah! Ah!
Why me, God? Why always me?
Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry! Oh, don't get the face, kid. I'm so terribly, terribly sorry. How can you ever forgive me? Are you hurt? Is anything broken?
Hey, Eureka. I know it's late, but do you really need all this stuff?
June, a girl can't be too prepared, and I spent 3 days picking those out, so just find a place to put them.
Yes, ma'am.
Thanks so much for helping me pack my bag.
It's no big deal, and it's kind of obvious that you're not very good at packing.
Oh?
Yeah, you need to consolidate the fragile things toward the center of the case. And you should wrap them with small articles of clothing, like this... panties?
Hmm?
Ah, I'm sorry!
You know, this is gonna sound really strange, but...
Huh?
Haven't you and I met someplace before?
Huh?
Don't you feel like there's some connection here?
No, honestly, I really don't feel like that at all, actually.
Oh, how very strange.
Eureka!
I'm coming! Well, thanks for all your help. Bye!
There's no way that's going in the trunk. Can we try the back seat?
Okay.
Huh? What in the heck is this? Huh? This... It's me! How? Why would that girl have a picture of me as a kid?
Don't you feel like there's some connection here?
Of course, of course, of course we've met before! Eureka! Eureka Misumaru! Oh, I can't believe fate has crossed our paths again! I have to know! I have to know! You're the only one who can tell me the truth! Eureka!
Say what? What do you mean you don't need us? We're Admiral
Fafner. He's an idiot.
He looks familiar. Didn't he drop his ship on the Mars colony? Still, I suppose you can't blame him for being upset.
There's nothing wrong with our crew, sir. Of course, they may be a little unusual, but they're all experts in their fields, and our captain has never been defeated in the simulations.
Ha! And just where is this miracle worker?
Well, actually...
Oh, this must be it! Hi, everyone! Have no fear, you're the captain's here! Me!
An idiot.
There's nothing like making a strong first impression.
Well, you see, sir, this guy just rode up to the front gate on a bicycle and started raising a ruckus.
Eureka! Let me see her!
Ah, I see. You must be a pilot.
No, I'm not! I'm a cook, dammit!
And he keeps spouting nonsense like that too, sir. He's a real loony.
Now, let's find out what your name really is.
A DNA database?
Here we go. How did you get to Earth from the Utopia colony after it was destroyed?
I can't remember. All I know is that I was on Mars, and the next thing I knew, I was here on Earth.
And Eureka? Why must you see her?
Back when I was on Mars, when we were kids, I knew her. I think she might know why my parents were killed.
I understand. You've had a tough time, haven't you? A cook, huh? We need cooks. Well then, you're in luck. From now on, you'll be a cook on the Nadesico. Who might argue with fate?
Nadesico?
Yes, the Nadesico. The ship won't be taking off for a while, so why don't you take a walk around and get to know her, okay?
Okay.
Let's go, Geki Genga!
Mr. Val is not a Geki Genga!
Crush you in my wrath! Finish you off with my Gekigan blade!
Wait a second, who are you and how did you get there? Our pilots aren't supposed to arrive for 3 days!
Are you kidding? When I heard we were going to be piloting real robots, I couldn't get here fast enough! This is the real thing, baby!
Will you stop that? Playtime's over!
Hey, you're talking to the greatest robo-pilot who's ever lived! And to prove it, I'll show you just one of my super amazing God Killer moves! Yeah. God Super Upper!
Geki Genga.
It's just like on Geki Genga. Every time I move my arms, the robot's arms move the same way. Am I a born pilot or what?
Actually, with the latest developments in image feedback technology, a newborn child would have done just as well as you did.
I'm Guy. Guy Daigoji. But you can call me Guy.
Well, this says your name is Jiro Yamada.
That's just a boring name my mother happened to give me. But Guy Daigoji is the name which belongs to my soul. Evil Jovians, fear my wrath.
Oh! Now what?
Yes, well, actually, it's my leg. I think I hurt it quite badly. Don't!
Of course it hurts! It's broken, you idiot!
Don't be stupid! It's fine! Ow! Hey, you up on the catwalk!
Me?
Is there anyone else up there? My most precious possession is still in that cockpit! Could you get it for me, pretty please?
God, a Geki Genga robot toy is his most precious possession? Just how old is that guy mentally? Wow!
Attention, what was that? Our ground forces are now engaged in combat with the enemy's tech.
Oh no, it's them!
All bridge crew,
they're here!
Report to the command center immediately. I repeat, all bridge crew, report to the command center immediately.
Why are they attacking out there?
Who can ever figure out what those damn Jovians are thinking?
That's true. I hope poor Kato's not watching this.
The enemy seems to be concentrating their attack directly above our position.
And you think the Nadesco's their target?
If that's the case, we'll hit them where it hurts!
What do you mean?
If we sweep the perimeter with the Nadesco's energy cannons, we'll burn them to a crisp!
Are you proposing to vaporize our own fighters?
Well, why not? They're gonna die anyway!
Would you call that cold-blooded or just cowardly?
Captain, do you have any suggestions?
The Nadesco will go through the underwater submarine dock and into the open ocean. Flank the enemy from behind and obliterate them. We'll need a decoy.
That's where Gaidai Goji comes in! I can engage the enemy with my giant robot and lure them away from the base! It'll be great! It's my destiny, yeah!
With the triple compound fracture.
I forgot that.
We already have a decoy.
Here's a robot in the main elevator shaft.
There's no way I'm gonna be trapped inside this ship. I'm just a freaking cook! I'm not going to get killed in some stupid war.
Identify yourself.
Huh?
Are you a pilot?
No.
What? That's my Geki Ganger! State your name and rank.
Akito Tenkawa, ship's cook.
The what?
Eureka, isn't that...
Tenkawa.
What the blankety-blank is he doing inside the cockpit?
He's from Mars. I hired him as a cook.
So what's a Martian cook doing inside my robot?
Akito?
Akito! It's Akito! Huh? I knew it! I knew it! I knew we knew each other somehow, Akito, and I was right, wasn't I? Did you just pretend not to know me because you're still shy, Akito?
Hey, wait just one second here! Just what are you doing on this ship anyway?
Why, she's the captain of the Nadesco!
That's right, Akito. I'm the captain of the Nadesco. Pretty cool, huh?
Eureka, do you actually know this person?
Mm-hmm. He's my knight in shining armor. Whenever I was in trouble, Akito was always there to help me through it.
Can I get a word in here?
Oh, but I can't let you act as a decoy against the enemy.
Huh? Act as a what?
But I know how devoted you are towards conducting your mission, and mere words from a Senomoto woman wouldn't sway you, will they?
Well, they might.
All right. I'm entrusting the fate of the Nadesco and all her crew to you, Akito. But promise me that you'll come back alive.
Alive? Hey, wait!
The elevator is about to reach ground level.
Wait!
Good luck and Godspeed!
Give me back my catching tanker!
Just shut up!
You have 10 minutes. Just keep the enemy occupied. Good luck.
I'll trust you with the fate of the Nadesco and all her crew!
Supposed to be able to fight! Use the cannons!
At least throw a punch at him!
Actually, he's doing quite well! You shouldn't ask for
Akito,
a better decoy.
I will not let you die.
Landing of submarine dock at 80%. Opening underwater doors. Engines, ready to launch.
All right, Rory, take us out.
All engines, forward thrust.
7 minutes? How am I supposed to keep running for another 7 minutes? I've had it with this, dammit! Enough is enough!
Hey, that was cool! It's just like a Gekigan punch in that old cartoon! Oh, the hell with it! Okay, you lizards, you want a piece of me?
I'm actually not too bad at this pilot stuff after all.
But what's the difference?
Ah!
It hasn't been 10 minutes yet, has it?
I rushed the schedule for your sake!
Enemy units are now within our effective range of fire.
All right, let's fry some bad guys. Fire!
Whoa! Situation report, Miss Hoshino.
All of the enemy were destroyed. Our ground forces were hit heavily, but only 5 deaths have been reported.
Only 5? It's just luck, a coincidence!
Recognize her achievements. Good work, Captain.
True brilliance.
Mikito, you were really amazing out there!
Now wait a second. I didn't come here to save you or anything like that. I just came here to see
me?
You, and...
You came to see me?
No, I just saw this and I came to find...
That picture! You came all this way to bring it back to me? Oh, you're just too good for poor little old me!
Will you stop? I've got a question to ask you and it's important, so shut up!
A question? You mean that question?
Yes.
Oh, you're rushing ahead!
I'm not!
Yes, of course. I know you didn't mean it like that. First, we'll have to spend a lot of time together.
I'm a little worried about the future here. At least it looks like it'll be interesting.
I want my Gekiganger back, Fry Boy!
Will someone listen to me?
But Akito, I already know exactly how you're feeling right now!
You don't know anything about me! You're making me unbalanced!
There's even love over me!
You want to know what I'm thinking? The truth is that I...
Love me?
No!
I love you so very much!
I'm gonna listen to someone else for a change!
Nadesico has set sail, but lo, the hands of evil are attempting to corrupt the wings of our beloved Nadesico. Why must brother fight brother? Why must a beautiful captain hold back her tears in the face of cruel fate and a dramatic separation? It's a barrage of breathtaking, suspenseful moments as the Nadesico departs on her maiden voyage. Don't miss the next thrilling episode. Leave the Blue Earth to me!